This week, United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres said the world needed an exit ramp off the highway to climate hell. And it comes after the planet just marked 12 straight months of unprecedented heat. According to the European Union's Climate Monitoring Service, every single month from June 2023 to this past May was the world's hottest month on record. Joining me now for more is Dr. Michael Mann, Presidential Distinguished Professor of Earth and Environmental Science at the University of Pennsylvania, the director of the Penn Center for Science, Sustainability, and the Media, and the author of the great book, Our Fragile Moment, How Lessons from Earth's Past Can Help Us Survive the Climate Crisis. Dr. Mann, it's always an honor to have you on my show. I have first for you a very simple question for which I am sure has a very complicated answer. But my question is, why is it so damn hot?
Yeah, thanks, Katie. It's great to be with you. And that's not a hard one. The heat that we're seeing, the extreme weather events, the melting of ice, all of those real-time disastrous weather extremes that we're reading about now are a consequence of the steady warming of the planet due to the burning of fossil fuels. It really is that simple. We are reaping what we've sown. We have continued down this path of increasing extraction and burning of fossil fuels, and now we're seeing the consequences.
Dr. Mann, what can we as individual human beings on this planet do? I know we can't reverse it. I know the damage has been done, but what can we do to slow it down?
Yeah, thanks for that question, because we understand the urgency of climate action. That's very clear. What's sometimes less apparent is the agency that we still have. As bad as things might appear, they are basically what we predicted we would be seeing at this point, using models that we have that can forecast the warming of the planet, given different scenarios of carbon emissions. And what those models also tell us is that the warming will basically stop when we bring those carbon emissions to zero. So we need to decarbonize the global economy. We need to do so rapidly. But if we can do that, we can prevent the further warming of the planet and the catastrophic consequences that would come with that. Now, as you allude to, we are stuck with a certain amount of warming and impacts already. There's a certain amount of climate change that's baked in now. It's still within our adaptive capacity to deal with those changes if we can prevent further warming by acting now.
Dr. Mann, I am loath to bring politics into science or medicine, but I think it's important to note that during Donald Trump's first term as president of the United States, he overturned an estimated 100 environmental regulations and pulled the U.S. out of the Paris Agreement, shrank the EPA, and required that the words climate change be removed from the EPA's website. How important is it, Dr. Mann, to make sure that whoever ends up in the Oval Office understands the exigency of this moment and how important it is to protect the globe from climate change?
Well, obviously, it's critical. This is the greatest challenge that we face as a civilization, is an existential threat. And without American leadership, and we've seen this before, when America leads on this issue, other countries come to the table, and we need all countries on board acting together to address this crisis. When the U.S. doesn't lead, when Donald Trump pulled out of the Paris Accord, that signaled to the rest of the world that we weren't serious, and we saw China, for example, start to go back on their commitments. And so it is so critical that we elect a president, and all the way down the ballot, from president down to dog catcher, every choice that we make has to consider the impact that it's going to have on the planet, and we need to vote for climate champions and vote out, basically those who are simply rubber stamps for polluters for the fossil fuel industry. Unfortunately, that does now essentially fall along partisan lines today. That's the world we live in.
Dr. Michael Mann, I am out of time, but I am going to have you back very soon because I do think that this is an important topic that we always need to highlight. But I appreciate your time today with us. Thank you.